Today's news bulletins are DSM Sinochem Pharmaceuticals wins Indian patent infringement case against Sinopharm Pharmaceuticals. DSM, which is a global leader in production and commercialization of sustainable enzymatic antibiotics, next generation stains and antifungals, recently announced that the High Court of Delhi has granted a permanent injunction against Sinopharm Pharmaceuticals for patent infringement in India. The permanent injunction prevents the manufacture, use, importation, offering for sale and sale of amoxicillin antibiotics, which is active pharmaceutical ingredient in India, as well as any drug product that utilizes the active pharmaceutical ingredient. Columbia Asia hires Dr. Kelvin Loh as CEO to navigate its next phase of growth. Columbia Asia, one of the fastest growing healthcare companies in Asia, has appointed Dr. Kelvin Loh to serve as CEO effective July 1st. Dr. Loh worked the past 8 years at Parkway Pantai, most recently as chief executive of company's Singapore Operations Division. He previously served as CEO of Parkway's Mount Elizabeth Hospital and Mount Elizabeth Novena Hospital in Singapore, and before entering healthcare administration 16 years ago, practiced as medical doctor. Scientists to test whether Zika can kill brain cancer cells. Scientists in Britain plan to harness the Zika virus to try kill brain tumor cells in experiments that they say could lead to new ways to fight an aggressive type of cancer. The research will focus on glioblastoma, the most common form of brain cancer, which has a 5-year survival rate of barely 5%. Zika causes severe disability in babies by attacking developing stem cells in the brain, but in adults whose brains are fully formed, it often causes no more than mild flu-like symptoms. G20 health ministers agree to tackle antibiotics resistance. Health ministers of the G20 leading economies meeting for the first time on Saturday agreed to work together to tackle issues such as a growing resistance to antibiotics and to start implementing national action plan by the end of 2018. Germany, which holds the G20 presidency this year, said it was an important breakthrough that all nations had agreed to address the problem and work towards obligatory prescriptions for antibiotics. That's all for today. Thank you so much.